Good evening. Welcome to Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks. I'm your host, Kendra Cook. I'm filling in tonight again for Amanda. And with us this evening, we have two different historical societies represented. We've got Vicky Heffner with the Berks History Center right here in Reading. And we also have Lindsay Dierolf with the Boyertown Area Historical Society. So welcome, ladies, to the show.
Hello.
So glad to have you with us, and we've been talking about all the cool stuff in the lounge before we started, so we're going to dive right in. Vicky, over at the Berks History Center, we've got a lot of food-related things coming up, which is exciting to me. So
we are celebrating Foodways in Berks County, actually, the entire year. For example, in January, we did a program, a blog on how to make pig stomach.
Oh, yes.
We did Fosnucks.
I read that. Yep, very interesting.
That
yes.
And then I made Fosnucks in February, and Syme did a clam pot pie that we featured. So our Berks County Conference, this is our third annual conference, is a Foodways featured conference with four very well-known historians that will be presenting that day.
Oh, wow. So do you pick a theme every year?
We try to.
Okay.
Last year we didn't have so much of a theme. The first year we did Pennsylvania Germans.
Okay.
And we wanted to try to do Foodways since food is popular.
Yes, especially those Pennsylvania Germans, yes.
And we have, as I said, four very well-known historians coming. For example, Alan Kaiser. You might know more of a textile historian, that's how I identify him. However, he's been working on a book for most of his career, and last count it was about 600 pages, so it's very thoroughly researched. And his presentation is Pennsylvania Dutch Foodways, and what he's done is he's studied diaries and receipt books and different things from a couple of hundred years ago, and that's what he will be presenting his information on. We also have Bradley Smith, who is our museum curator at the Berks History Center, and he is going to be talking about reviving local spirits, whiskey distilling in Berks County, which I know, Kendra, your husband has a special interest in. And he did considerable research in Schaeferstown, which has a very large distilling in the basement that's been researched in that particular house. So he will be presenting his information on what he found there, and then distilling in general.
Wow. Actually, my husband's from Schaeferstown,
He probably knows Brad then.
I don't know, but I remember going to that that house or homestead. And
it's incredible when you go downstairs to see the big, huge hearth that was used. And then they have like that very large wine cellar that's in there with the vaulted roof. It's really impressive.
It is really neat.
So he's going to be great. We also have Erwin Richman, who is works at Landis Valley. And his title I love, it's called The Berks County Radish and Other Tales. And he has co-authored a number of books with Mike Emery. And so what his description says is Berks County's agricultural roots grow deep. Focusing on heirloom and heritage seeds, Richman will uncover how agricultural products have shaped local popular culture and American history in an illustrated presentation.
Wow.
So I believe he's done four books with Mike Emery over the years.
Wow.
and very knowledgeable. In the afternoon, Dr. Clarissa Dillon, I don't know if anybody, if you've seen, she's very interesting. I've gone to a number of her presentations over the years, and she will be talking about how colonial people survived the winter during the Revolutionary War before and after Valley Forge, since the soldiers took so much food from the area, how they were able to survive that very particularly difficult time during the war.
Wow. Good variety.
It is a good variety.
Yeah, we've got some good speakers
I should mention
there.
The date, too. It's April the 21st.
Yes.
We didn't mention
I
that.
I have this little banner up here on
great,
the screen.
That's great.
It has the date listed on there.
It is $60 for non-members and $50 for members. Registration's at 8:30, and we wrap up by 2:30 in the afternoon, and lunch is included with your registration.
Okay, so it's like two morning presentations, mm-hmm. a little break, and then
yep.
two afternoons.
Mm-hmm.
All right, very cool.
And to kick off our conference, our food waste conference, we are having a beer fest. The previous Saturday, the Berks History Center has 10 months out of the year, a second Saturday program. Mm-hmm. So to kick off our conference, we are doing a beer fest, and it starts at 9:30 with breakfast, and then at 10 o'clock there will be a lecture by Chad Campbell, who is a well-known beer historian, Berks County beer historian. And then following the program will be beer tasting, provided by Oak Brook Brewery. And Chad Campbell, along with his friends, have a very large collection of beer things, like signs and bottles.
Yeah.
And we've done an exhibit at the Historical
very
Society,
cool.
so you'll get to see the exhibit as well as Chad Campbell's presentation. And we're asking that people purchase their tickets online for this particular mm-hmm. event. Because we do think it's going to sell out.
Yeah.
And we'd like to sort of manage it a little bit better.
Sure.
So it's $12 for members and $15 for non-members. If you are a member of the Berks History Center, you can call in and purchase your tickets that way. However, our non-members, we are asking that they do it online by visiting our website at www.berkshistory.
Okay. Very cool. Very cool.
It's exciting.
And Oak Brook, of course, is a local...
Yes.
Brewery, which, you know, I guess is trying to get some of that vintage flavor in their
they
site,
do,
too.
They do, definitely.
It's a neat place.
And they've been a supporter of our organization in the past.
Yeah. They seem to be into our history.
Yes. So. Well, and they're located in a historic firehouse.
Exactly, yeah.
And they took it back to what it looked like about 100 years ago, which is really neat.
Wow. Yeah, you have a few images here. I know we have not a lot of time, but I know some of these, I guess, are maybe what's going to be on display
exactly.
with this event. So, of course, Reading beer we had to feature, right? Mm-hmm.
So I would like to also just mention one more thing in connection with mm-hmm. our Food Ways theme for the year. On September the 14th, I run bus trips for the Berks History Center. So on September the 14th, we're having a Berks County beer tour, mm-hmm. and we'll be visiting four breweries in Berks County, and we will be eating lunch at one of them.
Very cool.
So if you're interested in getting a brewery tour, the people who own the breweries are going to talk to us for about an hour, and then you'll also have beer tasting at all four of the locations. And that is September the 14th. If you're interested, call in. I'd love to talk to you.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
Very cool. Of course, you know, there's other, non-food things going on at the History Center,
yes.
too.
Mm-hmm.
Although it's a food year. So again, if people want to check out the Berks History Center, the website is?
It's www.berkshistory.com.
Okay. And that's where you can buy tickets for the beer mm-hmm. fest or the brewery thing on the 14th. And keep an eye out for the conference next week.
I hope I see you, Kendra.
I know. This is really exciting. I said before, my husband's already purchased tickets for the brew thing. So you'll at least see him. Hopefully me.
Please tell him to introduce himself to
I
me.
Will.
I've never met your husband.
I'll let him know. Yeah, he'll be on your bus tour, too.
I hope so.
Also with me this evening is Lindsay Dierolf, and she's with, again, the Boyertown Area Historical Society. Lindsay, I guess, first of all, for those who have not been there, Boyertown Historical Society, of course, in Boyertown, when was it founded? I know it's been around for quite some time.
We were founded in 1972. sort of in response to an urban renewal project that was going on in Boyertown. A group of people got together in an attempt to save a building that was slated for demolition. We met for a couple of years at the local school in the library, and then in 1974 we bought our own building, which had formerly been used. It was built in 1903 as the home of George Unger, and they lived there for about 20 years. In 1921, it was sold to the Allentown Archdiocese to be used as the St. Columbkill's Roman Catholic Church, and they were there for about 50 years. So the building we're in currently has a lot of history. The core of it was a very well-built Victorian mansion, and then over the years while the church had it, there were several additions and installation of beautiful stained glass windows.
Yeah, I love the windows there. They're really neat.
Yeah. When the sun comes in, they're really nice during the day when the sun's shining on them. So we have a lot of history from those two things, and then of course
is that the photo that you had this evening?
Yes, the one of the yeah. original house and
beautiful porch too.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I love it.
That's what the original house mm-hmm. looked like. There is an addition on the front now.
So that was the Unger house, and then very cool.
We're in the process of trying to get it listed on the National Historic Register, so we're keeping our fingers crossed that our application is approved.
It's a tough one.
That's awesome.
And Boyertown, as some of you might be familiar with, is the home, well, the birthplace, and during his childhood, the home of General Carl Spots. And in June, there's going to be a big celebration recognizing him. There's a picture up on the screen now of him with his dog. I think he was being upstaged by the dog, and he's trying to maybe look at her to tell her to behave. But we'll be putting a large exhibit together. Probably we're shooting for an opening in mid-May.
Okay.
To have a large, we have things that are on permanent exhibit all the time on General mm-hmm. Spots, but we want to enlarge that and also include some other military things. So we're going to be working on that in the next couple of months.
Very cool. Yeah, it's amazing. I think a lot of people, I mean, he was so high up in mm-hmm. the military, and he came from right here mm-hmm. in Berks County. Mm-hmm. And I mean, Spots Airfield, but, but it's amazing. I wonder how many people know that name so much anymore, so we're trying to get it back out there, right?
Yeah, he did a lot of things for the military. Was very, very much a part of having the Air Force set up as a separate branch of the military. Up until World War II, it was part of the Army. It was the Army Air Corps, mm-hmm. and then I don't remember exactly what year it was, but. After World War II, it was set up as a separate unit
entity.
Of the military.
So I know you have that coming up this year. What else is there going on in the galleries? Any other, or the collections? You have a great library as well. I have used it many times.
we do have a research library, which is pretty busy during the week. We have hours on Tuesday evenings, and then during the day on Wednesday. And it gets pretty busy in the library during those hours. And then we have special events and exhibit openings scheduled sometimes on weekends. We're not open every weekend, but when we have a special exhibit or a special program going on, we do open up during the weekends to feature those things.
Well, when you say when you're open the 2 days a week, is it the library and the museum part?
Yes. If you come in during, those regular hours, you're welcome to walk around the museum area as well.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And I think also this year, It was the 110th anniversary, correct?
Yes.
Of the Opera House
Rhodes
fire.
Opera House fire.
Yeah, which was a huge part of Boyertown's
history.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
The fire occurred on January 13th, 1908. So as Kendra was saying, it is 110 years. 170 people, which is approximately 7% of Boyertown area's population, was lost that mm-hmm. night. And that fire and several other fires similar to it around the same time period are responsible for today's building codes, fire safety laws. Mm-hmm. One thing that people in Boyertown are proud of is that one outcome of that fire was that now doors on all public buildings need to open outwards.
Yeah, because that was one of the causes of so many lives that were lost, was
right.
that they got trapped, right,
mm-hmm.
as they were trying to escape. But I know one thing that you guys did, which I think is so nice, is the wreath laying at the cemetery too.
Yes, usually in January, the Sunday closest to the anniversary of the day they buried the last 24 victims is we have a wreath laying to honor those what we call the unidentified. There were 24 people who their bodies could not be identified after the fire. We knew who was missing, so they do mm-hmm. have names on the headstone, but we couldn't match a name, or they couldn't at the time match a name with each individual body that they had found. So they're called the unidentified, but it's a little confusing because
right,
there
we
are
know
names.
Their names, but we didn't know who was who.
Who was who? Yeah.
Yeah. But it's a nice annual event, I think, to remember
yes.
those people
yeah.
and all that died in that fire, which was mm-hmm. absolutely terrible. But it's nice that you guys are there to still pay respects to them. That's,
yeah,
that's great. We're almost out of time. So before we go and we'll wrap up with both, where you can get more information about both of these really great organizations. So Vicky, you're again, if you want to know more, you visit mm-hmm. the website.
Berks History Center website is updated and beautiful mm-hmm. compared to years ago. I'm sure your
yes,
website
it does.
your websites look much better today than they did years
yes,
ago.
Yes.
I know. It's true.
And it's very accessible. You can find out about bus trips that we have, member events, and almost every single one of our events is open to non-members.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely visit. And our museum is open Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. and then Saturdays we're open from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. The library has different hours and they are open Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and then on Saturdays from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m.
Also a great library. You guys mm-hmm, have a great
definitely.
Library too.
Thank you.
Yeah. I've used both of these libraries mm-hmm. a lot. Lindsay knows because I bug her with questions all the time. And then
we're only two blocks away from each other,
I know.
So it's handy.
Like, I'll just walk over and see if Lindsay knows the answer to this.
I really loved your recent exhibit on sweethearts around Valentine's Day.
Yeah,
I have wanted to get to it and I didn't.
Oh yeah, the wedding dresses.
We had fun with that one. We found old love letters and put out wedding dresses.
Yeah.
Yeah, we really had fun doing that one.
I think it's and both of you, you know, there's so much stuff in storage that doesn't always get
exactly.
to see
mm-hmm.
a lot of mm-hmm. screen time, you know, out there. It's neat when
whereas you, most of your stuff is on display.
It's so
correct?
Big. I
can't put it. It's not like you can use hide-end.
You can't hide it in a closet.
No, no, I can't stuff it in the attic, unfortunately. But yeah, I think it's neat when you get to rotate that stuff. And it's always, like, so check in with them because there might be, you know, a new reason to come. You might have a new exhibit out. And you folks, we visit on BoyertownHistory.org, I think.
BoyertownHistory.org. us is our website.
Yep. So both of them, great places. I hope everyone at home takes the time to visit them, go support their great events and exhibit openings coming up. And I guess that's all we have for this evening. So thank you, Vicky.
Thank you,
thank you Lindsay.
Thank you.
For coming this month. And we will be back in April. So see you all then.
Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks on BCTV is supported by the Berks Heritage Council.